They say that brewing the perfect beer is more art than science. But let's not forget about the engineering that goes into the process as well. We all know the key ingredients of a good beer. Just look at the label. Malted grain like barley or wheat, hops, yeast, and water. Pretty basic. But arguably, the most important variable in the brewing process is always going to be temperature. And to craft a consistently good beer, you need to monitor those temperatures throughout the brewing process. Here's how it's done. First, malted grain is milled so that the outer shell of each grain is cracked open, helping to release its starch. The milled malt then goes into the mash mixer, where sensors monitor the temperature of the hot water used to reactivate the natural enzymes in the malt, causing the starch to convert to sugars, which dissolve into a mixture called mash. The mash then goes to the lauter tun, where the sugary liquid called the wort is separated from the mash. From there, the wort goes to the brew kettle, where pressure and temperature sensors monitor the process as the wort is brought to a boil, and at the precise time and temperature, hops are added to give the beer its flavor. After boiling, the wort is cooled and then goes to the fermenter. Yeast is added to the cooled wort. The yeast consumes the wort's sugars, converting them to alcohol and carbon dioxide, giving the beer its kick and its carbonation. And since the fermentation process also produces heat, temperatures need to be monitored here as well. So there you have it. From microbrews to brewing giants, the key to success is consistency, and the key to consistency is monitoring and controlling temperatures throughout the brewing process. Want to know more about what's brewing at Omega? Call or chat online at omega.com. Thanks for watching and be sure to like and subscribe.